All right there, my name's Ragtag and I'm the greatest gutter tier gamer on the face of this earth. Today, I'm going to show you how to calculate your rank in Season 2 of Apex Legends, which I am totally qualified to do, by the way, thanks to the fact that I am the savior of this Battle Royale game. I mean, I single-handedly feed the matchmaker more than anyone else in the world by jumping in hundreds of times a day to meet the same grisly fate in a meaningless death moments later, only to rinse and repeat immediately afterwards. Yes, sir. I have the awareness of a sedated chinchilla, which truly makes me champion of the chumps, lord of the losers, and master of the mediocre. So in case you haven't heard yet, Season 2 of Apex Legends is right around the corner, and the ranks available to us are going to be Bronze, Silver, Gold, Platinum, Diamond, and Apex Predator, which gives you a 6-tier system to salivate over when, let's face it, half the players watching this video are going to be licking their chops at the thought of the top 2 ranks, when in reality, the chances of any of that happening are the same as them ever getting a girlfriend. And for those of you thinking about piping up that you've already got one, don't worry. She's going to realize that you're a pathetic loser in the coming months, and then you can enjoy matrimonial bliss with your PC or console. I realize I've just excluded the 6.2% of my female audience when I made that condescending comment, but I'll think of a way to insult them as well so that we are inclusive with our abusive verbal spoutings of the nonsensical diarrhea. Anyway, I am also going to predict for you where I think that I will land in terms of Season 2 rankings towards the end of this video. And once you have seen my analysis of all the ranks, let me know in the comments where you think you're going to land. Bear in mind that at the time of making this video, we don't have all the information about how ranked works. So calm your G Fuel fingers the hell down if you arrive here 2 weeks later, because this video spiked due to my soaring popularity. Because apparently everyone loves to share my uploads with their Yankee Danky Doodle shite friends to inform them that Shrek actually has a YouTube channel. Absolutely fucking hilarious, dude. Well done. You're a comedian. You made it. Every time I see that comment, I think IQ 9000. This person is the only one who understands how difficult it is to make YouTube videos from a swamp. But while you're all up there in your fancy castles, just remember, at least I don't need to flush the toilet. I live in one! Right, we are actually coming to the rank calculation in a second, so bear with me, because something that people have been worrying a lot over with Ranked is that with the inclusion of our new hero, Watson, someone who is designed to create these little loot camp enclosures with her fence and all that, Ranked mode is going to be chock-a-block full of people who sit around on the rooftops, high ground vantage points, and the top of supply ships, or perhaps cowardly scumbags who will get their finest ghillie suit skins on and hide in the bushes just to increase their survival time, thinking they're going to get a chance of a shinier badge. Yes, I think that is going to happen, you're right, but most of the players who do this are absolutely garbage anyway, so this annoying tactic might not help those arseholes rank up as much as they think, and here's why. For a ranked mode in Battle Royale to actually work, you should look at what separates the amazing players from the truly terrible. The chances of this mode being dependent on just your wins and placing in the top 5 alone, I don't think that's very high, and if it somehow did become that way, then I think this game is going to die pretty fast. The more likely solution is damage done, weapon accuracy, eliminations and assists, not to mention making good on your role in terms of how much you heal as a lifeline or how many unsuspecting nublets are getting gassed by caustic traps. I think survival time will probably still count to some extent, but the simple fact is, good players wreck everything. Bad players find an appropriate excuse to protect their fragile ego, and me? Well, I felt my testosterone leaking up my nutsack just like the loser next to me, so I embraced the shiteness. I mean, once you say that you're a bag of shite, what more can anyone do to you? Right, let's calculate those ranks and stretch this video out over the 10-minute mark like a fucking boss, and each of these are going to be based off of what happens right now in unranked play, starting with Bronze. This rank also exists in a game called Overwatch as well, and I can tell you that it is a truly bizarre place to behold. The majority of people who exist in this rank will be using inappropriate PC hardware, and to keep referencing Overwatch, I once did this series called Toxic Coaching, and I basically took a look at a VOD of someone playing in Bronze, and yeah, this guy, I think there was a girl actually, who used a character called Mercy, basically a healer who holds down one button to do their primary job, but their movements were so inexplicably dog shit that I started to suspect that this person could not be using a mouse to control their movements. It didn't look like a controller either, and they were on the PC. At the time, I joked about them using a trackpad on a laptop or something along those lines, and yeah, that's exactly what was going on there. If you have a rusty bucket of bolts for a PC, or if you like to use your PlayStation or Xbox while lying down on the sofa whilst your family constantly walk past the TV, you will likely be sitting at a disadvantage before you even make it to the dropship. It will come as no surprise that that is the kind of person that ends up in this rank. What else? Bronze ranks will be the kind of players who you think they might have DC'd because they're actually standing still out in the open, to the point where you're thinking, wow, That might just be Mirage bamboozling me, but no, it's just another pathetic loser who plays video games in slow motion. Fast-paced FPS games are just not the Bronze Rank's forte, and whilst they enjoy them, most of their career eliminations happen by accident. Looting is slower than a three-course meal for the bronze player who will study every new piece of gear intently before making any kind of decision. Attachments require a great deal of time to decide if they are necessary or not, and they probably get Skull Piercer and Precision Choke mixed up. Combat is an area of confusion where the direction of fire in their direction is impossible to locate until you see the squad eliminated screen and you find your enemy is actually teabagging your filthy corpse. Winning games for the bronze player is as rare as a total eclipse. Moments like these are often photographed and framed to put on their shelf, next to the 7th place ribbons and participation certificates from their sporting school events. But to say that the bronze player knows nothing about Apex Legends would be a complete lie, because the lowest ranks contain some knowledge that some players don't know anything about. The inside decor of the respawn ship, for example. Silver. This rank is where we have graduated from euthanized donkey to being the kind of player who does actually get some intentional eliminations now and again, but they tend to do so under these idealistic terms only, and for combat conditions to be truly correct, the silver rank will choose drop locations that allow them the time to adequately kit themselves out until such a time that they feel able to fight it out. The silver rank will be utterly flustered if combat comes to them before they are ready, and a skillless seizure will electrify their muscles to make the very definition of spray and pray come to life before their very eyes. Sometimes this will actually pay off by sheer luck alone, reinforcing this method to the brain that blind panic does actually work now and again. The weapon knowledge of the silver player is clearly better than bronze, but they will often forget to reload in combat before jumping helplessly and pressing other unintended buttons in their panic, resulting in a death that they can readily blame on this incident where if they didn't accidentally push their ultimate or tab to their inventory, the fight would have been theirs. Silver players will quite happily go through a normal unranked game, surviving to the end with one or two eliminations by either hiding from big gun battles or by running after the person who is literally carrying them across the finish line, which of course the silver player will pat themselves on the back for and delude their deoxygenated brain sack that they are actually getting better. Gold. No longer completely useless at this game, the gold rank is the gold standard of average. Victories will be theirs, perhaps even a few times a week. The gold player is able to make better use of the ping system and perhaps has some understanding of strategy. Glimpses of skill will shine through when they have a good idea now and again, but the ultimate price of having awareness with an extremely inconsistent skill set is that this rank will know exactly what they want to achieve without ever being able to pull it off on a daily basis. So the gold rank will experience good days and very, very bad days where nothing ever goes right and they wonder why they aren't in the toilet with all the other bronze ranks. Unafraid to mix it up somewhat with the busier drop zones, the gold player marches on with specific loadouts in mind that they are comfortable with and have a proven history of winning matches with. However, to a gold ranked player, the wingman is a weapon for hackers and clueless players who just get very lucky, so they will prefer shotguns and LMGs, weapons that pack a punch without ever having to think about the concept of headshots. Combat awareness for the gold rank will be, well, let's just say it'll be okay. They will start to understand when to use the terrain to their advantage for fighting and will keep a closer eye on their health and shields to start thinking about exit strategies and pause moments to recharge. However, this will often come at the expense of positioning in relation to their teammates and often break down into moments of dumbfuckery, indecision, and what the player will later come to rationalize as bad luck. Getting a few eliminations in a normal game will satisfy the gold player who was clearly held back by his unhelpful squad mates, and to make sure that they get those eliminations, thirsting is mandatory even if their teammate badly needs help while fighting two other enemies at the same time. Getting that confirmed kill before you go down makes the end screen stats easier to justify when that loss comes in, but really, sitting in gold, the potential to rank up will always feel like it's just around the corner until you get there and it's actually a dead end, you silly wanker. Gold players also spend a lot of time picking each other in fights, making them have more epinephrine injected through their chest than any other rank in this game. Platinum. Finally moving into the better than average category, the Platinum player is a versatile individual who has a more flexible outlook in Apex Legends with regard to weapon loader and general strategy. The skill set of this player can be very dangerous to an opponent in short bursts, as they will be able to start making quick instinctive decisions and become more reactive to changing circumstances in combat. However, when things really hit the fan and there's a lot going on, the Platinum player will almost always fold and resort to their mechanical skill, often standing their ground at key moments where they should actually otherwise change position. Sometimes this will pay off and they will get the better of their opponents, other times they will get completely wrecked, and those who remain in Platinum will never learn the difference between what would have been more optimal and simply drawing it down to bad luck with another team getting in and ruining an otherwise dominating game. High ground becomes more important to engaging enemies, and a Plat player will frequently seek it out, particularly to trap those who are coming in from a previous ring zone. However, with the mechanical skill being better than average, it is not perfect. So when a skilled squad rushes upon them, a perfectly laid out plan is not always adaptable enough to deal with the swift aggression of attackers, which can devolve the Plat player back to the seizures of silver. Platinum players will think a typically good game is 4-6 eliminations and anything from 500 to 1000 damage. Every so often they will pull out 10-15 kills with insane amounts of damage done, making them feel absolutely jacked for the rest of the week. There will also be a screenshot on Twitter with the caption, "I'm a goddamn beast at this game." Diamond. Beware of the diamond rank where the dedicated and the knowledgeable reside. The wingman is the friend of this player, and they utilize the skull piercer to brap their enemies frequently. This is a fast-moving individual who is always thinking ahead in terms of the ring, audio positioning of their team and enemies. For PC players, this is a guaranteed 144Hz monitor with a decent rig. DPI and sensitivity are finely tuned. Console players have comfortable gaming chairs, headsets, and they sit forward with a killer instinct in their eyes. Diamond players don't use the word high ground, they just take it, and are constantly moving around in combat, predicting the movements of their enemies, instincts about timings, and whether or not they think someone will recharge their shield according to the distance between them and their victim are constantly considered. And even if they are misjudged somewhat, the mechanical skill of the Diamond player will see them and their R99 slide the barrel of that SMG right into the mouth of their quivering foe. Misdirection will be a common tactic of the Diamond tier, with people feigning one way before going the other and happy to charge into combat with confidence, knowing that even though they might get down for their aggression, the damage caused will often be enough to turn the tide of a multi-way battle. Less than 1,000 damage done in a game for a Diamond player will feel like they were somehow carried, with 6-9 eliminations being completely standard. 10-15 elims is really good, and anything over 15 gives a certified EP boner, which you can expect to have a couple of times a week. Apex Predator. Now these are the guys that end up on the highlight reels, the compilations, the ones who are constantly spectated for fear that they are in fact a filthy hacker, because the Apex Predator is a one-person wrecking machine with ruthless aggression who will happily 1v3 anybody on a frequent basis. They don't care what weapons are available at the start of the game, because their Mozambique versus an enemy Spitfire will still result in that Spitfire being pulled from the cold, dead fingers of that fallen corpse, while their imaginary girlfriend seductively drops grapes into their mouth whilst swooning over his gameplay. The Apex Predator is that one arsehole who can play door games in buildings better than anybody else. They love fighting people sliding downhill, always seem to be able to recharge their shields at the exact moment the enemy is looking for them, but of course they're not going to find an Apex Predator, and that's because the Predator themselves is actually behind you, having looped around and smashed their prey right in the teeth. You don't hunt this tier of player because they are hunting you. They know the map so well they don't even need to think ahead for cover or general terrain usage. It simply flows as their combat adrenaline constantly fuels their body, and the start of each new game frequently lands them up to 6 eliminations within the first 60 seconds because they are the champions of the blue circled hot zones. The inside of a respawn ship is something that the Apex Predator has never seen in their goddamn life, but they are well acquainted with the respawn beacon, which they will frequently look at as they run past, remembering that their dogshit teammates don't deserve that res after all, because they are on their way to get a career high elimination score. They are an Apex Predator, and they have absolutely no life whatsoever. And so now we have estimated what kind of rank each player is going to fall into, I will take a guess at where I think I am amongst all of these tiers. Whilst I often joke about me being gutter tier, which is definitely still true in many respects, because I have been guilty of aiming down the sights at close range with the Peacekeeper in the past, mainly because I didn't trust my dogshit vision, I think I have actually gotten better at this game, so I truly do not believe that the rank system will put me in bronze. Now that I've sat and thought about how many games I win on average, who I queue with, how often I get carried, the weapons I roll with currently, and how often I die, I would say that I will very much likely land in gold. This should be quite a populated tier for average players everywhere, and I would like to hope that I could rank up into Platinum across Season 2, if I can stop some of my donkey habits. Well, that's my guess. Where do you guys think you're going to place in Season 2? Pop a comment below, and that's going to do it for now. Leave a like on the video and subscribe for more of my bullshit. I'm out of here. Later.